My name is Spenny Clendenen. I have been an ECR RCR employee for 34 years this summer. I've held almost every position in the engine shop that's available other than being an engineer.
Spenny's been in our engine shop. He's moved from different departments and everything, and today he's running our financial side of it and doing a great job with that.
I am currently, they call me business manager, but I'm really just kind of a financial analyst. I make sure that we have more money coming into the business than we have going out. I had an automotive machine shop that was, it had grown to 10 employees. As business was not doing well at all, latter 84, 1985, we had two kids. My wife said, I want my kids to go to college. It's time to close the shop down. You go find a job. So I had worked with a mutual friend, Bob Grell. He did some cylinder head work for me on the race motors. So I told him, I said, you know, if anybody needs a machinist, he said, yeah, Richard Childress is looking for machinists. He's always looking for engine guys. So we were at the Charlotte race. We had led that race, but I snuck into the Cup garage, gave him one of my business cards. I said, my name's Spenny. I live in Abingdon, have a shop. I need to close it down, need a job. Turned around, left, and called and said, I'd like to come visit. So him and Bill Patterson drove up there on a Monday afternoon about a week later.
You know, I went to Abingdon, Virginia one night. I knew Spenny was building engines for some late model racers that were winning races and doing really good. And I knew he had his own little shop up there in Abingdon, Virginia. I remember driving up there at night and he was in the floor working on an old four-cylinder tractor engine. And I thought, now, is this the same Spenny Clendenen that builds these other great engines?
He's called me a tractor mechanic on occasions because when he came to visit, I had still had two guys working. I needed to have something for them to do. So we broke down a tractor in the parking lot to be able to rebuild the engine. So I've never driven a tractor in my life, but he called me a tractor mechanic. He's called me that ever since. But I came down here, there was some misunderstanding in the engine shop on why I was here and what my job was to be. So I'm not sure if it was with Richard's knowledge or not, but I was fired 4 days later. But ultimately, 5 weeks later, Richard picks up the phone and says, hey, I think maybe we made a mistake. I need some help in my engine shop. Would you please consider coming back? So by that one phone call right here, right there, that has helped keep me here this long. That makes you want to be dedicated to Richard Childress.
So we sat down and we talked, and he came down and we talked more, and I hired Spenny. It's one of the best hires for our engine shop that we'd ever made. We've had some great engine builders and great people, but Spenny is so dedicated to RCR. Just so proud to have him and be able to call him a friend.
Me being more an engine guy than a racer, I have enjoyed being here and I've concentrated on these engines. My wife raised our kids. She raised our family. I was doing what Dale and Richard needed me to do. So I was headstrong into what we were doing. And it was very important that we do that. Obviously, it helped us win championships and I can't even keep up with the amount of races. I'll tell you a story about Dale Earnhardt and Victory Lane. It was Martinsville, 1995. I was chief engine builder. And Scott DeYoung was building our qualifiers, and he built a really good short track qualifier. Dale sat on the pole at Martinsville. I went up on Saturday morning. Danny catches me and he says, Dale wants to see you. So I go up on the truck and Dale sits down and he says, good qualifier, but I don't want qualifiers like that if I can't have them to race. So he was kind of chewing my butt a little bit. So he goes on, they put the race motor in, he has a great practice. Next day, he dominates the race, wins the race, gets on TV. I'm back home listening to it on TV, and he says, I gotta apologize to Spenny. this motor was as good as the qualifier. It ran great.
And we are back at Martinsville Speedway in Martinsville. Can you think they're celebrating here? The Goodies 500 is history, and Dale Earnhardt gets a big hug from Teresa sitting here with Taylor and Nicole. And Dale, congratulations.
I tell you, got a hand of this race team, mate. And then all the guys worked hard back at the shop. So Spenny's engine ran great today. I was on him a little bit about the qualifying package. It's a bit better in the race. It's a good race engine today.
Dale had a real appreciation for everything that everybody here did on his car, because Dale Earnhardt had to do all of that for himself at one time in his career, just like Richard Childress. So that's why they worked together good. That's why they had a real appreciation for the employees, because they had to do all this work for themselves at one time.
Earnhardt had a way of picking at everyone, including me. And when he had called him Spenny Clendenen, we all got a big laugh out of it. Even Spenny would laugh about it.
I don't know whether he's in a hurry or he just wanted to say it that way, but we used to get the Clevite engine builder checks, and I've got five of those from the Daytona 300 races that have Spenny Clendenen on them. But those things are treasured. If we had had some sort of failure, the first thing he would tell me, he would say, Spenny, don't start chasing ghosts. Because, you know, there something caused this to happen, and we're gonna find it. He was constantly asking questions, and that was important. He would keep you on your toes. He understands pistons, rods, he understands all the things that make up those engines, because he had to do it himself. We're not allowed to have engine failures. Now we're very engineering based, and you don't see any failures at the racetrack. Back in the old days, we were hot rodders, gathering what we could, changing what we could to make it work. So yes, we would have a failure, but he was very demanding at that we had no failures. When Dale Earnhardt was driving the car, had an engine failure, that was the headline the next day. You don't remember who won the race. So it was that type of situation. And that's one of the reasons that Richard Childress is who he is and has been doing this for 50 years. We had a bad weekend. That was after we had started doing some rental things and we had multiple cars here. So overall, it was a bad weekend. I don't know that we had any failures, but it was just a bad weekend. So Purdue was one of our many good sponsors that we've always had. So they furnished us these stress relievers. Well, not a stress reliever ball, but a stress reliever chicken. Well, Richard comes down Monday morning, has one of these in his hand, he's squeezing it, he says, Spenny Gage, you supervisors, we want him back here in the conference room. He doesn't want excuses, ever. He wants reasons, he wants answers. So he's sitting here squeezing this chicken, and the guys are talking, and he's looking at me the whole time. So the whole time he's doing this, he finally gets to the point where he starts jerking the poor little chicken apart. And he's throwing the pieces of the chicken at me. So our meeting gets over, we get done. I asked Sharon, our receptionist, to go back and gather the pieces off the floor. I taped it back together, and I guess I'll die with this chicken, because I saved his life. It was a big part of my career, and that little Purdue chicken's gonna be with me forever. Our engine shop grew from where we had six individual people to these multiple shops, and we finally put it together. So I was overseeing the growth of RCR Engine from six people to 90 some people. We merged with engine shops with Dale Earnhardt Incorporated. Probably a good thing we did. RCR Engine would have lasted forever, okay? But it just needed that influx of capital, needed an influx of people. Early on when we first merged, we had a huge shop. We actually operated out of three different facilities. We had we still had people down at DEI. We had people in two different buildings here. So we were looking for other things to do, and we had done some IMSA stuff early on. And of course, we were constantly looking at the DPI program, because GM had wanted us to get involved in that at some point in time. IMSA or Daytona Prototype has a rules package that you have to follow very religiously. So there's just a very fine line of areas that you can work in. So these guys take a lot of pride in what happens there. There's not before suppliers in Cup now. You know, you have TRD, Yates, Hendrick, and ECR. So it takes a group of people to be just 1/4 of the Cup field. It takes a lot of engineering base to do that. We have design control over everything we do now. In the early 2000s, I had 2 engineers. Now we have 12 engineers. So there's a big difference in how we have progressed to operate. It's just been a natural progression for me to see it grow from what it was in 1985 to now. I'm proud of the fact that we used to buy a $30,000 dyno. Now we have multiple $3 million dynos. That we are a world-class engine development center. It's taken a lot of people to help Richard and Judy get to this point. And you think about the people that have come and gone. You think about the people that have left and came back because it's just a good place to work. It's comforting. Richard picked up the phone and said, "Hey, I made a mistake. Would you come back to work for me?" Through all of the people that's been here, through all the drivers, there's been one constant, and that's Judy and Richard Childress.